Bitcoin. What is Bitcoin? Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency, or we can call it a digital currency. Our Indian rupee is issued by the Central Bank of India. Dollar is issued by the Central Bank of America, and pound is issued by the Central Bank of England. Since Bitcoin is a currency, which central bank issues it? The answer is none. Strange as it may sound, but it is a fact that though it is a currency, it has not been issued by any central bank. So which country does Bitcoin belong to? The answer is also none. You may say it belongs to the internet. And since it's a digital currency, it has got no physical presence and we can't touch it. It appears only on screen, just like we see coins while playing computer games like Mario Brothers or Candy Crush. We all remember that on 8th November 2016, our Honourable Prime Minister declared that the Rs 500 and Rs 1000 notes won't be valid anymore. At 8 p.m. before the announcement, they were a currency, and at 8:01 p.m. after the announcement, they became a useless piece of paper. So a paper becomes a currency, and a currency becomes a paper only on the approval or disapproval of the central bank or the government. And since Bitcoin has not been issued by any central bank, its value must be zero, right? But no. In 2018, one Bitcoin was worth around 14 lakh rupees. This is incredible. $1 is 70 rupees, 1 euro is 80 rupees, but 1 pound is 90 rupees, but one Bitcoin touched 14 lakh rupees. But while recording this video, the value is 7 lakhs. So how can a currency with no physical presence, belonging to no country, and issued by no central bank, command a price of this magnitude? When was it issued? It came into existence on 3rd Jan 2009. And why was it created? The founder says he created Bitcoin after the 2008 financial crisis. So who is the founder? Who created Bitcoin? Now this is a huge mystery. The biggest of our generation. As they say, everyone loves a mystery, especially an unsolved one. 10 years since it has come into existence, we have no clue about its founder. The only thing we know is the founder goes by the name of Satoshi Nakamoto, and without a doubt, the person is a genius. Watch out for our next video in which we will try and unsolve the mystery of Satoshi Nakamoto. So let's get back to Bitcoin. How do we create a Bitcoin? To create a Bitcoin, all we have to do is mine them using blockchain technology. But rest assured, we don't have to use shovels or drills or hammers or pickaxes. Let me explain further. We require only three things to mine Bitcoins. Number one, a computer with internet. Number two, electricity. And number three, a cooling system. We all probably have these three things at home itself. So bingo, we can all produce or mine Bitcoins. Just go to bitcoinmining.com and make a user ID and then start mining. So how do we mine it? We have to solve riddles or puzzles. Now that sounds tricky, but once again, rest assured, the riddles are solved by the computer itself. We just have to log in and the software will do the needful. The PC which solves it first gets the Bitcoin, just like fastest fingers first. How much does it cost to make a Bitcoin? Since the entire cost of mining Bitcoin is electricity, it is majorly mined in countries with cheap electricity rates. Also, since their machines run non-stop for a month, they require continuous cooling. So countries such as Iceland, Russia, China, which are naturally cold, are best suited for mining Bitcoin. The cost is generally 1 lakh rupees, but it differs from place to place. So what are its uses? Since it's not issued by any central bank, we can hardly buy anything from it. It's predominantly used for illegal purposes, like blackmail, extortion, ransom, or drugs. In fact, in 2017, the computers of the founder of Knowledge Capsules were hacked and he was asked to pay 1 lakh worth of bitcoins just to get back his files. He bought bitcoins online and paid them the ransom to get back control of his PC. Many world leaders have said that youths and teenagers are buying drugs using bitcoins, so it should be completely banned. Are there any rivals of bitcoins? Yes, there are more than 1,000 varieties of cryptocurrencies now in circulation. for example Neon, Ripple, Ethereum and more. But just like we remember Neil Armstrong for being the first man on the moon, and Edmund Hillary and Tenzin Norway for being the first to climb Mount Everest, in the same way with Bitcoin being the first, it's the most popular. So how many Bitcoins can be mined? Satoshi Nakamoto, the genius, knew that if he allowed unlimited Bitcoins to be mined, then it would lose its value, just like air, water, sunlight, which are in abundance and have no intrinsic value. So, he programmed the software in such a way that only 2.1 crore Bitcoins can be produced. Since 2009, approximately 1.5 crore Bitcoins has been mined, and the remaining 0.6 crores, or 60 lakh Bitcoins, will be mined in the next 120 years. Yes, you heard it right. The first 1.5 crore has been mined in the last 10 years, but the remaining 60 lakhs will take 120 years. The last Bitcoin, that means, will be extracted by 2140 AD. So how's it possible? The Bitcoin software has been built like our computer games. Just like as we go up, the levels of Candy Crush or Mario Brothers become tougher and it takes more time to win. In the same way, puzzles get more complicated and duration to solve increases. For example, if today it takes 10 minutes to solve and get a Bitcoin, the next might take 20 minutes and the next 40 minutes and so on and so forth. So why did the prices of Bitcoin go up so dramatically? There are rumors that it would be accepted as payment gateway in Amazon and other online sites. It was also allowed to be traded on major stock exchanges, and big investors were buying into it. So naturally, the prices shot up. Now don't miss our next capsule in which we will try and unsolve the mystery of Satoshi Nakamoto. In this capsule, we have tried to answer all questions relating to Bitcoin, best to our knowledge and ability. But if you have any queries, please feel free to ask in the comment section. However, the chances of getting an answer is almost nil, because we are as clueless as you are. Thank you for watching.